Hi students, today is 23rd of April and we will start with the new module, module 4. In module 4 you have actually two important topics. One is flow over bodies, which deals with many equations like Prandtl equation, boundary layer conditions, what is a drag force, what is a lift force, all those concepts come into a one part of your module 4. And on the other part you have a very simple and easy concept of dimensional analysis. And if you see the dimensional analysis, we have a small introduction to it. You should understand what is derived quantities, what are the different dimensions of physical quantities involved in fluid mechanics, what do you mean by dimensional homogeneity. There are some methods by which you can check the dimensional homogeneity. One method is Rayleigh method that we have to see. We have to go through a very important theorem called Buckingham Pi theorem, and based on this particular theorem we will be having a sure shot numerical question, a lengthy question, minimum of 10 marks in your final examination. Okay, and we have something called dimensionless numbers. There are many dimensionless numbers, concept of similitude and types of similitude. So we will go through this part of your module 4, that is dimensional analysis, which is much simpler compared to flow bodies. And then we will get into the other part. Okay, fine. So if you want to come to, or if you want to go through this, I have shared this textbook with you. So open your Archibald textbook. Chapter 12 deals with dimension and dimensional and model analysis. So we will go through this particular part. Okay, in regard to your model. Then if you see what is dimension analysis. If you want to introduce it, introduce the dimensional analysis. It deals with, the dimensional analysis is dealing with the dimensions of the physical quantities that is involved in a phenomena. It may be a process also. What are the basic dimensions which are involved in a particular physical quantity? The physical quantity may be density, it may be a force, it may be velocity, it may be different entities, like it may be acceleration. Okay, you are going to write it in terms of the basic, what you can say, fundamental units, that is, or the fundamental dimensions that are involved in all these physical quantities. Okay, so this is a technique in which a mathematical technique that is very useful in research work when you are doing some designing or you are conducting some model tests. Okay, when you are simulating something, this dimensional analysis comes into picture and this becomes very important. Now if you see, there are something called fundamental dimensional quantities. Okay, there is something called fundamental dimensions or fundamental quantity. You can also call this as fixed dimension. What are these? These are nothing but, okay, the all physical quantities. They can be measured by comparison made with respect to a fixed arbitrary value, and that involves the three basic things, that is length, mass and time. And if there is a temperature involvement, then the fixed dimension for temperature also should be considered. So all the physical quantity can be expressed in terms of length, mass and time and temperature. So these are called fixed dimension or fundamental dimension or fundamental quantity. So let me repeat it again. Your length L, mass capital M and time capital T and the temperature theta are the fundamental dimensions that you are going to use. Okay, you can compare any of the physical quantity with respect to these L, M, T, theta. Okay, so they are called fundamental quantity, fundamental dimensions or fixed dimensions. Okay, now what are secondary quantities or derived quantities? The secondary or derived quantities are those quantities, physical quantities, which are possessed with the possess more than one fundamental dimensions. So if there is a quantity which involves more than one fundamental dimension, like if there is a quantity which involves L and M, then it is a secondary quantity or a derived quantity. If there is a quantity which involves L and T, okay, length and time, then it is a secondary quantity or a derived quantity. Okay, so for example, if you take velocity, how you define velocity, it is displacement over the time. And displacement you can measure with the help of what you can say length, right? It is put in terms of meters, so it is length. So length per unit time, right? So L by T you write it, velocity. Similarly, if you want acceleration, it is L by T squared. If you want to think about the density, then it is M mass by volume. So volume can be written in terms of basic dimensions of length into length into length, L cube, right? So we are just saying acceleration is L by T squared, right? Your density is M by L cube. See, we are involving more than one. See, there are two fundamental dimensions. So these are secondary derived quantities. Okay, they are very important. Almost all the quantities which we are using in fluid dynamics or fluid mechanics, then they are all what you can say secondary units only. Okay, secondary quantities or derived quantities. You need to remember all most of them. Okay, you have length, mass, and time, which is a table which shows everything about the physical quantity, what are the symbols, capital L, M, and T, dimensions L, M, and T. Okay, if you see some of the area, okay, area you will put it as capital A, but the dimension is L. Volume, it is L cube, area is L squared, okay. Velocity is L t to the power of minus 1, angular velocity is t to the power of minus 1, omega. And acceleration is L to the power of L into t to the power of minus 2, angular is t to the power of minus 2, angular acceleration, only t to the power of minus 2. Discharge, you will have what? It is L cube into t to the power of minus 1, okay. So much volume in a particular time, volume divided by time. So L cube into t to the power of minus 1. Acceleration due to gravity, L into t to the power of minus 2. Okay, you have kinematic viscosity here. See, kinematic viscosity will be L square t to the power of minus 1 in the fundamental quantity. So you need to remember almost all the things. See, force, ML t to the power of minus 2, very, very important. Okay, your weight, mass into acceleration, ML t to the power of minus 2. So if you remember, this particular table has to be memorized by you. If you can memorize these all fundamental all secondary dimensions, okay, these dimensions are very, very important. They are very much required in your problem. If you know it, then half of your work is done. So I want you to, okay, write down this particular what you can say table and read this particular table or go through this table again and again so that you get familiarized with all this, you can say, secondary derived quantities, dimensions. Okay, I want you to do that. Please do it. Okay, do it by yourself. It requires some practice. If you write it again and again, memorize it again and again, you will be able to do it. Okay. Now, if you see some of the problems here, simple problems. Okay, let us see some simple problems. Determine the dimensions of the quantities given below. You have angular velocity, you have angular acceleration, you have discharge, kinematic viscosity, you have force, specific weight, and dynamic viscosity. So for these seven quantities, we have to put in terms of dimensions. So angular velocity, it is the angle covered in radians divided by time. See, angle covered in radians for theta, whatever angle it is covered, we don't have any fundamental dimension. So we put it as 1 divided by t. For time, we have t to the power of minus 1. Similarly, angular acceleration is radian per second square. So for radian, we don't have any what you can say fundamental quantity. Fundamental dimensions are not there. But for second, we have time. So t to the power of minus 2 will come. Discharge, you can find it by area into velocity. So when you are finding area into velocity, it is L square, area, into L divided by T. Your velocity is L by T, so L cube by T. You can also write it as volume per second. So L cube T to the power of minus 1, you will get. Both also are okay. Kinematic viscosity is mu divided by rho. How you are getting actually mu? Mu you are getting it from the Newton's law of viscosity, where tau is equal to mu into dou u divided by dou y. So mu will be tau divided by dou u by dou y. We call it as a velocity gradient. This is shear stress. Okay. This is q change in velocity with respect to distance. So velocity L by T, distance is down, so 1 divided by L. Now shear stress can be written as force by area. Now if you expand it, okay, force is MLT to the power of minus 2. How we are getting it? Mass into acceleration. Okay, mass into acceleration, L by T to the power of 2 divided by force per area, so L square will come, okay, into 1 divided by T. If you work it, okay, at the end you are getting a viscosity, kinematic viscosity as MLT to the power of minus 1 into T to the power of minus 1. So this is very simple and you can do it. So from basic formula only we are actually deriving it. Okay. So if you remember the final equation also it is fine, but if they ask you to expand, you have to do it by this method only. Okay. There is nothing much difficult over here. You have to actually try it out. If you try, you will get it. Fine. Next, for density, it is mass by volume, so m by l cube, so that is done. Okay. Next, you have this is for the upper part actually. Okay, for the mu part, dynamic viscosity, m l t to the power of m l to the minus 1 t to the power of minus 1 is for the dynamic viscosity. But they have asked you to find kinematic viscosity. Kinematic viscosity is dynamic viscosity divided by density. So now if you divide it by density, after cancelling out of all the terms, doing simple maths, L to the power of 2, T to the power of minus 1, the remainder. Okay, I'll just make a correction over here. This is for dynamic viscosity. This is for kinematic viscosity. Okay, mu by rho formula. Now, force, mass into acceleration, I told you how will you get ML to the power of minus 2. Specific weight is weight by volume. Okay, so weight can be also written in terms of what? M into G, or can write it as force also. Weight is a type of a force, or the best way, which method you know, weight is mass into gravity, mass is M, gravity is an acceleration, so L into T to the power of minus 2, volume is L cube, so M L to the power of minus 2, T to the power of minus 2, that's specific weight. Okay, dynamic viscosity, we have just told it here how we are going to get it. Okay, this is a simple problem, okay, which depicts you or tells you, shows you how you can find the dimensions of different quantities, okay, that are involved in a particular phenomena or in a process. Okay, with this example, I will end this video. Please go through this video. If you have any doubt, you can definitely ask me. Thank you very much.